Over the years, I've seen many patients who express that they feel drunk or hungover even though they don't drink or weren't drinking alcohol. This can be incredibly frustrating and confusing, but it happens and there is a reason for it. Hi, I'm Dr. Stephen Wangen, the founder and medical director of the IBS Treatment Center. If you don't drink alcohol or are sober, but you often find yourself feeling drunk, or you often feel like you have a hangover and are recovering from a night of binge drinking when you weren't doing that at all, this is for you. This experience is known as auto-brewery syndrome. And as the name states, you are literally brewing your own alcohol. But how does that happen? Well, alcohol is produced by yeast as they feed on sugars from carbohydrates. And this process is well understood in the world of beer and winemaking, but it's essentially the same thing that can also occur in your digestive system. It's considered a rare condition, but I suspect that there are a lot of more people out there suffering from this than we realize. Doctors aren't particularly used to looking for it or diagnosing it, and I believe that many cases are being missed and that it's underdiagnosed. If we're lucky, maybe we'll learn more based on the number of people who watch this video and comment on it. I'll be really curious to see what happens here. This condition can be caused by several different types of yeast, and even a few bacteria have been reported to be the cause of auto-brewery syndrome. The yeast include Saccharomyces cerevisiae, Saccharomyces boulardii, and various species of Candida, including Candida glabrata, Candida albicans, Candida kefir, and Candida peripsilosis. Woo, I think I got it. Candida peripsilosis. The bacteria Klebsiella pneumonia, the bacteria Enterococcus faecium, bacteria Enterococcus faecalis, and Citrobacter frundi have each been implicated in at least one case report of this condition. And all of these organisms are capable of producing ethanol, which is what causes you to feel like you've been drinking alcohol. Now, Saccharomyces cerevisiae, which is one we mentioned earlier, is the yeast that's used to brew beer. And one of the patients that I saw with this syndrome had actually been a home beer brewing judge for several years. Now, he had probably ingested too many really poorly brewed beers and essentially seeded himself with a lot of this yeast. But you don't have to be a beer judge to develop this problem. Candida is found throughout the environment and everyone has been exposed to it. And if it has decided to make a home in you and to take over a significant portion of your digestive tract, then you too can suffer these same types of consequences. Now keep in mind that just because one of these yeast or bacteria shows up on a stool test does not mean that you have this syndrome. They must be colonizing your digestive tract in high enough amounts and you must have the proper strain of these bacteria or yeast. So fortunately, this condition is treatable, and you will feel a whole lot better once you have gone through the treatment. But it can be difficult to find a doctor to acknowledge that you even have this problem, right? Much less treat it. Now, changing your diet may also help, and you should know that sugars and carbohydrates directly feed into this problem, as you might suspect. However, changing your diet alone is often not enough to fully treat auto-brewery syndrome. You will likely need a doctor to help you with the treatment. And although it's treatable, it's not always easy to go through the treatment. Yeast tend to be difficult to treat, and the process itself can stir up a really horrible reaction that makes you want to discontinue the treatment. And this reaction is known as a Herxheimer reaction or the Candida die-off effect. And I have another video on that topic, on the Candida die-off effect, that you might enjoy watching. Now, if you suspect that you have this problem and you need help, please don't hesitate to contact our clinic. We work with people all over the U.S. and in over 30 different countries via Zoom and telemedicine. and we would be happy to work with you too. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more information on yeast and other things that can dramatically impact your health. Thank you for watching.